Hi guys, so good evening, welcome back to my magical world. I am Frostbite, and if you are new to my channel, welcome. So currently it's 9:04 in the evening, and a while ago, guys, just gonna tell you a story. But like, I'm not gonna fully tell you the exact thing that happened. But so I went out with a friend, so we ran, and after that we ate dinner, and then something like really embarrassing happened there. So of course I'm not gonna tell you the entire thing, but I just want to say it here. Okay, so that's it. It was amazing day. It was I almost died laughing a while ago, and it's so crazy. Today is really a crazy day. So let's read, guys. So I'm gonna read for you. I can't stop laughing. I remember. Okay, so our topic for today. Okay, let's go back. Okay, inhale, exhale. Okay, so our topic for today is passion is powerful. So every person has the potential to be passionate. Everyone loves something. We are shaped and motivated by what we love. It reveals our passion. So enthusiasm is a choice, not a result. So ignore what you are passionate about, and you ignore one of the greatest potentials inside you. Nothing significant was ever achieved without passion. So keep following this success principle from Ecclesiastes. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your might. So most winners are ex-losers who got passionate. The worst bankruptcy in the world is a person who has lost his enthusiasm, his passion. So when you add passion to a belief, it becomes a conviction. Conviction gets more done than belief ever dreamed. So the starting point of all the accomplishment is desire. Keep this in mind. Feeble desires bring feeble results. Just as a small amount of fire makes a small amount of heat, be passionate about your life. So act from your passions. The more energy you apply to any task, the more you will have to apply to the next task. So desire is like planting a seed. It causes something to begin to grow. Deep desire creates not only its opportunities, but its own talents. Attitudes alter abilities. It's passion that persuades. So a strong person for any object will ensure success, for that desire of the end will point out the means. So that was from William Hazlitt. Okay, so we're not yet done reading, guys. I just want you to notice those people who are passionate at what they do, whether that's pottery, you know, acting, what do you call this, being the doctor or the nurses, like they do it with such enthusiasm, such grace, that you can see their love for the thing, for their craft. Okay, so those were the things that are actually not measured by any amount of money, because they are actually fulfilling their purpose, you know, their soul mission the moment they enter this earth realm. So you don't have, what do you call this, you can see right through their eyes that they're on their right path, because they're doing their thing, diba? Just like I do. Okay, so the trouble with many educated men is that learning goes to their heads and not to their hearts. Does the path you're traveling capture your heart? So you gotta ask that yourself, guys. Are you sure that your heart is there? Like, whatever you are currently pursuing. So you gotta ask that yourself. You don't wait till the time is too late, right? Because eventually it will be. It's too late. Of course, we have limited time here, as much as I know, because of so many factors, okay?
So you have been sent into this world to do something into which you can pour your heart. You will be remembered in life only for your passions. Find something that consumes you. A belief is not just an idea a person possesses. It is an idea that possesses a person. So learn to be comfortable without being enthusiastic. So every time zeal and passion are discussed, someone brings up balance. Balance is itself is a tremendous virtue, but its immediate neighbors are apathy and weakness. So if the truth were known, being balanced is usually an excuse for being lukewarm, indifferent, or neutral. Three traits that are always attached to failure. Enthusiasm can achieve in one day what it takes centuries to achieve by persons. So proverb says, above all else, guard your affections, for they influence everything else in your life. Okay, guard it, guys. Don't just pour it out to the wrong people. Okay, you gotta learn from me, guys. I poured that to the wrong people in my past, but I'm different now. Okay, I'm pouring this all for you guys. You know, people that actually here with me, with my journey. Let's proceed reading, guys. So William James said, perhaps the greatest discovery of this century is that if you change your attitude, you can change your life. Put a smile on what you do, it adds to your face value. This is this one. You see this? This is face value. Right? When your enthusiasm increases, stress and fear in your life diminish, passion is powerful. So when you're driven by passionate conviction, you can do anything you want with your life, except give up on the thing that you care about. Pessimism never wins. So Mike Murdock said, what generates passion and zeal in you is a clue to revealing your destiny. So what you love is a clue to something you contain. Life is a passion, or it is nothing. So Without passion, man is a mere latent force, and a possibility like the flint that awaits the shock of the iron before it can give forth its spark. So that was from Henry Frederick Emile. So that was like an idiomatic expression. Learn to depict it, guys, okay? So passion is the spark for your fuse. In fact, the bigger the challenge or opportunity, the more enthusiasm is required. Follow this advice for a successful life. So there are many things that will catch my eye, but there are only a few that catch my heart. It is those I consider to pursue. As Terence Deal sagely notes, believing is seeing. It's much more effective than the old notion that seeing is believing. If you have the right desire, the distance doesn't matter. Love the thing you do and you will keep doing better and bigger things. So you don't actually to be good at, you know, when you start a thing. Okay, I have to remind this to the young generation, guys, to you especially. You don't actually to be like an expert the moment you start doing it, because it's not supposed to be perfect. Okay, when you start doing something, you start to figure things out, and then you learn something that, oh, this is one, this thing is needed, this instrument is needed. So you learn every day. You learn, you become more confident, more passionate, more resourceful on what could make it, of what craft, you know, the craft that you're doing to make it improve. Okay, so things like that, guys. So okay, guys, so this is like a really funny day. So it's so funny, guys. I almost died a while ago laughing with my friend. So anyways, guys, I just want to thank all of you for having me here tonight. Okay, so thank you guys for listening, and thank you for helping me make this world a better place for all of us and for the future generation. Our affirmation today is laughter is the best medicine. Diba? So make sure to have the time for yourself, you know, self-love, self-care, all of that.